GunninGamerz here.
Episode 16.
That is right. Sweet 16, we're finally here. This is going to be one of our most unique episodes. It may be our shortest. It may not be. We don't know. This is going to be our beginner's guide. I've had a lot of people ask us on Twitch and YouTube that are new to the game that want to learn how to play the game. They come in here on the first day and they really don't know what to do. So Aiden and I are going to go ahead and show everybody. This seems a little bit weird for me to do because we've already had 15 other episodes and a pile more of videos that we've done on Twitch, hunting all these animals using all the fancy gear. I think there's almost not a piece of gear that I don't own, and Aiden has about half to three quarters of the gear now. There's only a few of the exclusive weapons that I'm missing, but own all the calls and all the gear, all the camos and things like that. And it's kind of weird to just step down to the level that I was at almost 6 years ago when I started playing the game. Now, as I've said before, the game came out almost 6 years ago in March of 2009. I jumped in June, and I do remember when I jumped in being a little bit lost, but we also only had a couple of animals to hunt, and there was only a few weapons, so everything was simplified, and I actually played on a free account for about 3 years before I became a member back in 2012, and at that point, I went ahead, bought my first year's membership, and have been a member ever since, and plan to, especially now that multiplayer, and especially now that they've added so many reserves and so many animals. So we got plenty of time that we'll be doing a lot of walking and talking, so we're going to start out and take a look first at our gear. I will take a look in our inventory. As you can see, we are here in Logger's Point. That is the first mistake a lot of people make, is that I've seen people live streaming on Twitch and they're getting mad as heck at the game because they're not finding any animals they can kill, and they'll be on the wrong reserve looking for mule deer. You gotta make sure that you start on Logger's Point. I think Settler's Creek is the one that comes up at top on the list, and I think it's Whiteheart, because Whiteheart was the first reserve. It used to be the only reserve, and I think some people accidentally venture into there, but if you read when you join the game, Loggers is a place for mule deer, it's a place for beginners to go. So you must, if you're on a free account, you must go to Logger's Point. That's the only place that you're going to find mule deer. Once you choose your spawn-in location, now granted I do have two tents placed out here, you'll notice that there are two, you won't have these tents, these are things that I've purchased and I have, but there's two lodges, and either one is fine to spawn in and find mule deer. Now, the best places that I have found is, really the whole map is pretty good on mule deer, but a couple of hot spots, although they haven't been working out so great for me lately, I've had a lot of bucks that I've killed in this area, as well as, kind of all in the middle of the map. Another place that is very popular is, we call it Evil's Rock. That's, everybody knows Evil if you watch our live streams. He's one of our moderators and community members. This rock overlooks these lakes. He's leveled up quite a bit just playing for so many hours on this rock, and it gives you a nice aerial perspective without having to use a tree stand. So if you're brand new and you don't have any gear, I highly recommend go over and check this rock out right where I put this X. Very good spot. A lot of mule deer. This whole area in here in general is great on mule deer. Like I said, you'll find them all throughout the map. And everybody has their personal preference, but I can tell you that this lake area is great. My personal favorite that I had a lot of luck, not only on mule deer but whitetail, was also right in this area. Between this road and the water here, this area all in here was very, very good on some mule deer. I think I killed my biggest muley in this area. As far as the gear, I am using only free stuff. What I have here is the 243, and it's the gun that you'll get to use for free. You get unlimited ammo on a freebie membership, and then you'll get this scope with it, which is a 4x32. It's nothing fancy, but it's a scope. And when you don't have binoculars, it really helps to be able to get out there and see. Now, my 243 is not leveled up too much. I know I think I've killed about 50 critters with it. I think I just got over the 50. Haven't used it a lot, so I'm kind of going to be a little shaky with it, just like a newbie player would if they came in. Mine is not leveled out to a high level or anything like that. But do remember that when you're shaking a lot with your rifle, that it does get better with time. The more animals you kill, the more leveled up you get, and the more steady you'll get with your shot. I'm going to be carrying with the doe bleat call. I don't know if... because it's been so many years for myself, I don't think you get any other gear for free when you start. But do remember that a lot of this stuff can be purchased with GM, like your scent spray. GMs are what you earn by doing missions in the game. EMs are what you buy with real money. So you can earn some of these things, like the wind indicator. The scent spray would be a good thing to buy with your GM. And there's a few other things. You know, I don't recall if you can buy calls or not. I've used real money to buy all that stuff. So I know you can buy bait, things like that. But we're not taking any of that with us today. We're going to keep things real simple. And you'll notice that I've got one extra gun. This is the single shot shotgun, 12 gauge. Now, you don't get this when you start out, but you do have the ability to do the mule deer missions and earn your way to unlocking this shotgun, which you can turn around and earn GMs to unlock ammo. You have to come in and spend some time playing with the 243, killing the mule deer before you'll have enough GMs to buy the shotgun and then buy ammo and continue with the mule deer missions. And you'll be able to do the rabbit missions, which you'll be able to unlock some more GMs. Now, there is a point that you'll run into. You're not going to be able to continue with the missions because it's going to require you to use a sidearm or a rifle that you need to buy with real money. But the fact of the matter is, you can go quite a while. You can go forever with the 243 hunting mule deer. That's the first free animal. The second free animal, cottontail rabbit, as well as the new European rabbit that they just added, which you can, again, do missions to earn GMs using the single shot shotgun that you all bought for free. So I am only using stuff that is free. Again, this is a beginner's guide. So those of you that are experienced hunters, hopefully you enjoy the video, but obviously, you're going to probably find things that you've already figured out on your own, but this is really for the new player, to help the new player out. And Aiden and I want to do our part to contribute to the hunting community and helping other hunters and fans of our channel that have been on the fence about trying out this game. I highly encourage you. It is the best hunting game. It's one of my favorite all-time games. It's a phenomenal game. We're going to look at Aiden's setup here. Aiden is carrying today... Now, his kit, you can see he's got camo on. I'm wearing the freebie gear. Aiden, we're doing a little something different. I want to show what you can get for approximately $20. Or I should say $18 and some change, and that's US. That's 2,000 EMs that you'll get. And I didn't even spend 2,000 EMs on what we bought for him. The first thing that you'll notice is he's also using the 243 with the same scope. The binoculars, I think, are about 40 EM, so that's very cheap, and they're helpful, and I figured, you know, we'll go ahead and throw those in. He's carrying the doe bleat call. He's carrying the buck grunt call just to help have another call with. We've got him with the 12-gauge pump. This is my favorite shotgun. If you start out with one of the memberships, you will get this shotgun. I know it's in the 6 and the 12 month, I'm pretty sure. I think it might be in the 3 month, but a lot of the membership bundles come with this shotgun. But either way, if you do decide to buy it, I think it's around 500 EMs or something like that. It's not a whole lot. We've got the ammo, of course, for it, and we threw the scope in. Now, there's a lot of different gear you could go with. You could buy a bow instead. One of the things, though, that I like about the shotgun is the fact that the shotgun, like the bow, is very useful in that it can kill every animal in the game if you're using the right ammo, whether it's slug, whether it's the buckshot, or the birdshot, which is used on, of course, birds and the rabbit. So he's using gear again that you could get for under 20 bucks. And then we also threw in the Boone and Crockett. This is probably the best choice if you are gonna be hunting cheap and you don't have all the ability to hunt all the animals, and you're basically gonna be concentrating mostly on the mule deer, and it doesn't do anything for the rabbit, but you don't really need it for the rabbit anyway. Definitely Boone and Crockett is the best for deer, but you could also go with the Sneaky Summer or one of the other types of ammo that would work very, very nice as well. All right, Aiden, you ready to head out? We're going to get rained on, it looks like. I'm glad you have a hat on, because I don't. My head's going to get all wet.
It's not real honey.
Oh, this is not real honey. Well, I couldn't tell. It's so beautiful in here.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, bud. So we're going to go ahead and depart. Should I take the scent spray or not?
I think it would be a very good idea.
It would be a good idea. I think I'm going to go hardcore, because there's a lot of people that... you know, again, I don't work for the folks at the Hunter. I really don't have any interest in their business, but it really just ticks me off the way, you know, we won't beat around the bush. If you go to Steam, you'll see that this game right now, as in February of 2015, has mostly negative reviews, and I can tell you right now, and this isn't even an exaggeration, that I think 99.9% of those, and I'd say at least 95% of those, are just completely dead wrong. People, I don't know if it's the FPS crowd that are, you know, big fans of guns, and I am too, but I don't know what they expect when they come in here, if they think it's going to be Cabela's, that they spawn in and they can slaughter everything. This game focuses as much around realism as possible. Now, you don't have to tell me where, you know, real hunting and this virtual hunting differ, because I do real hunting in real life, and I definitely know. But if they made it completely realistic, I don't think anybody would want to play, because you could be in here for a week or two, like real life, and not see an animal. And I think there'd be a lot more people complaining. So they do have to do things that are somewhat unrealistic to make the game fun. It's a balance, and I think 95% of what they've done in here is pretty good. They're, you know, I'll say 90. I don't want to give them too much credit, but I'll say 90% of what they've done in here is really good. There are things that I think that, you know, should be changed, but the good news is this is not a game that you buy for 50 bucks. Hey, bud.
Hey.
And they're done. They walk away. Here's what you get, and they walk away. No, this game is always evolving. The business model has gotten tore apart on Steam as them being money-hungry, money-grabbing, just filthy. And it absolutely boggles my mind why people say that, because this business model, I mean, they've been doing this for years. Before a lot of other companies, it's not pay to win, it's not gobble up all your money. In real life, you know, if you want to hunt every animal and have every piece of hunting gear, it is very expensive. This game, I've spent a lot of money on it. I guess then you could say, yes, it has been an expensive game, but when I balance that out with the amount of hours that I get to play it, and the fact that I know I don't really see an end in sight. I don't see an end in sight, because every time I come in, the hunt is different, and there's new critters, there's new reserves. They're always adding and making things better and changing. And it's just one of those rare games that it never ends. And you really can get thousands and thousands of hours out of it. And there are plenty of people that do. And they'll probably tell you the same thing, that it's still evolving and changing. And yes, there's always small things here and there that we'd like to see different, and the developers work very closely with the community and on the forums, and they do make changes as necessary, when it's necessary. So, it just really just boggles my mind that the reviews that this game has gotten on Steam, and I know a lot of people in my Twitch live streams, they say, hey, you know, I've seen this game, I'd love to watch you play it, because I seen it on Steam. It was recommended, but I didn't download it because it the reviews. And it... it just... You know, like I said many times before, it just boggles my mind on the reviews. You read them, and they are just pathetic. People claim that they run around in the map, and they don't see any animals. Well, a lot of times they're on the wrong reserve. That's why they're not allowed to kill anything. And the other thing is, right there, what they said right in the first line, I ran around in the map for 3 hours and didn't see anything. Do not run around in the map, especially if you're wearing the gear that I have on today, which is the freebie gear. You don't have anything to help you with scent, and you're a little bit noisier than you would be if you're dressed like Aiden here. And so it's very, very important to crouch walk. If you're really in a hurry, you can do some walking. I did some walking out of the reserve just so that we could get on the road, get out of the reserve. But now that we're out here, oh, look at that. I was just about to do a doe bleat. Let's switch to our hunter mate. This hunter mate is going to tell you exactly what you're looking at. We've got a mule deer, which is good because I can kill that. And it, look at that. It's right in front of us. Now, I'm not going to lie, this is going to be a little bit more difficult than even I'm used to. Aiden, stay right there.
Okay. I haven't seen it.
Yeah, make sure your guns are loaded, too. I forgot to do that.
My shotgun is already loaded.
Well,
my
good.
Rifle is already loaded, too.
I got to get my single shot loaded. In case if we do run into a rabbit. You won't run into rabbits. That's something else I should mention. I've never seen a rabbit up on this lodge. You should spawn at the other one. And I will cover a few rabbit tips here in a minute.
And you could also get... If you're really trying to hunt a rabbit, it's a great team to get your crossbow or a bow and arrow. Go out, or even a shotgun, and well, hunt rabbit, how many you can kill? Any of you can kill, like 100 million rabbit every day.
Yeah, 100 million, that's a lot of rabbit, bud. Do you see this deer? We need to be real quiet right now.
Yeah.
And, I have people recommend in my live stream, hey, can you play some music? And that is a huge mistake. I'm wondering if a lot of people aren't jamming out to music or screwing around on TeamSpeak in a loud, noisy room when they play. But this game, it's very important to have your sound level up all the way. And I haven't even checked mine. Once in a while, I have to adjust mine due to recording and things like that. But it's very important to have that up all the way. Which I am doing. This deer might be walking away. Aiden, why don't you go ahead and let me call here, because I'm gonna take this first one. Save some bucks for Aiden here. Hopefully we'll come across some nice bucks.
Yeah, I mean I could kill all these tames.
Trying to be a little extra careful. And that's, you know, an obvious and something important to remember too is if you're coming in here in a freebie account, the game it is going to be more difficult than if you were to buy better hunting gear. But it's the same thing in real life. If you go out in real life, run around in the woods dressed like I am with a subpar rifle, hunting is going to be a little bit more difficult. But we want to definitely stay crouched because that helps our sight and our sound. We've got a little doe coming. Very important to get those audio cues, not only so you know where the animal is, but it helps you level up. We might have multiple. A lot of these mule deer, these doe, travel in packs of like six. And I've seen the bucks in packs, a herd rather, equally as large. Up to four or five buck. And sometimes they'll be traveling alone. So we'll just sit and wait. Going prone is even better yet. Why don't you go prone too?
Yeah.
And we'll just call this deer right to us. Hold on, bud. Hold on. I gotta focus on this. Put it right between the front legs. And there's our first kill. So the whole myth of spending hours upon hours upon hours of coming in here to play the game and not see anything, we have done in just a matter of minutes. I started it out at 8 o'clock. The in-game time, I think, runs 2 times faster. Even when you shoot, it's very important not to go run, because you'd be surprised sometimes, especially if it was a long shot, when you get up to the animal, what might, you know, be lingering around. So we'll go ahead and pick up this doe. We got a heart and a right lung. If you're shooting them from the front, put it right between the breastbone. But if you're shooting mule deer, very important to remember that the heart is carried right above the front leg. That's an instant drop. And if you are not good at hitting that, go right for this area above the front leg, and you'll get a double lung, which they'll drop a lot of times. Sometimes they'll run just a very short distance, but it is a definite kill. Any of these organs will be a definite kill. Of course, hitting it in the spine is a big problem with a lot of the newbies. They think headshots are the way to go. Maybe in real life, but the game kind of frowns upon that, it seems like. A brain will give you a quick kill, but it's very hard to hit, and it's not a safe shot. It's always best to go for these big organs, so do keep that in mind. There's our little doe. We've got some meat in the freezer, right? Pretty good. Important to note that if you're not a member, you only get free ammo for the 243. If you're a member, you get free ammo for every weapon that you own, and that is a really nice feature, because then you can come in here, not only kill every animal on every reserve, but you get unlimited ammo for every weapon that you do own. And sometimes I see people complaining because of the cost of the membership, which I think is crazy. A lot of people just complaining in general that they have to buy a membership like it's a very bad thing. And there are so many games that are set up like that that people are perfectly okay with. Again, it boggles my mind why they expect this one to be free all the time. You know, I could go on and on with the list of games that are free to play that if you want to actually go in there and play the game, I'll just throw one out that's one of my favorite, Planetside 2. You've got to throw a few bucks in there. But with Planetside 2, it's a lot more than a few bucks. This game here, you can get a membership as cheap as a couple of dollars a month. If you get the 1-year membership, it comes to like just over $2. And if you wait till a holiday, a lot of times they'll have 20% off sale. And so it really only costs, you know, a couple of dollars, $2 to $3, to have a membership to hunt every animal and have unlimited ammo. And I think that's phenomenal. If you're a fan of the game and you play daily or almost daily like I do, like Aiden does, you really, really get your money's worth. And I re-up ours. We do 12-month membership every Christmas, every December. There's always a 20% off sale around end of November, which is the Thanksgiving holiday here in the U.S. And they'll do like holiday, like around Christmas. Here is a feral hog. This is an animal that we could kill. Aiden and I have the membership, but this is not part of the freebie. Now, you can buy licenses. And again, they have sales on all this stuff, but we definitely want to, you know, get rid of the preconceived notion that this game costs a lot of money to have a membership, because it really does, and it's very affordable. And I guess the last thing I'll say is that always keep in mind, when you're playing a game of this caliber with this much work and development, these people aren't a charity. They're not able to work for free. You know, they make a great game. They've got a product. They allow you to play it, try it for free, And, you know, it's important to support games that you love and that are good, because then they can further develop them and have the people in line to do so. And so it's not a negative thing to pay for a game. I actually get disappointed when I see a nice game come along and it's just a freebie. And it has a very, you know, free model. And I'll throw an example out there. I think Giants should charge a lot more than $30 for Farming Simulator. I wish that they would charge $50 for it and give me a $50 game. You know, yes, it's nice to only have to pay $30, but I don't want just a $30 game. I want them to put more brands, more equipment, more DLC, more maps, more everything. Take the time, hire a few more people to create more content, and let me buy a $49.99 game. I personally think that'd be a lot better, but, you know, they currently don't do that, and I'm glad the Hunter doesn't do that either. If they would have come out with a $49.99 game 5 years ago, and that would have been it, none of us would probably be playing this game, because there wouldn't be even a quarter of the content here. So, Aiden and I are walking here, and it's probably important that we start doing a little bit of calling since we've put some distance. We're going to walk to a freebie tower stand. Again, jumping back to the map, we'll clear our map. There are, on Logger's Point, 3 free tower stands. Now, these tower stands are awesome place to go and set up. These campsites are used if you buy camping supplies, which, again, you can use GM. You can fast travel to these campsites. Or you can buy them buy camping supplies with real money, and you can fast travel quickly, which would allow you quick access to that stand and allow you a little bit closer to these two. I guess this one will be kind of right in the middle, be a wash, but these are great places. You can pretty much run around in circles, jump up and down in these things, and you won't scare any of the animals around. Over here, I talked about this lodge. There's actually a shooting range at this lodge, and forgot to mention there's a bow range, I believe it is, at this one. I just walked past it and forgot to show it, but if you have a bow, you can actually shoot any of your weapons there, but do remember that you'll be using your ammo. If you're shooting at these targets with a shotgun, it'll use your ammo. It'll also use your 243, but again, that gets replenished for free. This one here has a clay and a rifle range. So you can go over here and shoot, practice honing your skills.
I threw a pig.
Now, you can walk around in the map and do a lot of calling as you walk, and you might cue a verbal response from an animal, but one of the things you do want to keep in mind is that, and you'll see this if you are observant enough and take your time, that I called back there. If I was to go and walk up here and really take my time, I might actually get some animals that will come to that call. Now, they might not have given me a verbal response, but you gotta be careful you don't walk around calling the whole time, because sometimes you'll pull animals from around you and you'll be calling them to a location that you aren't at anymore. And so you gotta think about what you're doing when you're using these calls. But sometimes I'll walk around and I'll really take my time and I'll call the entire time. Just to see if I can get a verbal response, but we're going to try to make it to this stand before we do a lot of calling, because I don't want to call all the critters over here. All the mule deer.
We're actually almost there.
Yep, we are almost there.
Put a wand. I put a mark.
Something else too, a tool that is recently new a few months back that we didn't have for many years, was that you can press G, and you got Lane Bandit, you have to buy that game, but Bust Through, if you're really a newbie and you're bored out here, you could play some Bust Through. A little bit of this game. And my high score is embarrassing. Apparently they wiped the stats, because I had a decent high score for a few years ago, but that's basically what that is. And then we have the camo. That's what I wanted to point out. The camo view. And right now it's basically saying dark gray, which means we don't have any camo in this spot. But if you're using... And it's going to say the same with the Boone and Crockett, because that's really a good camo for only antlered animals. It's not going to work for non-deer species. So if you're using like Sneaky Summer, you could press G and check your camo, and if that lights up all green, then that means your camo is working and you're good. If it's not, you probably want to change your location if you're trying to get an animal real close to you. Alright, Aiden and I have made it to the tower stand here. All you gotta do is walk up to the ladder and press E to get in. And there's Aiden, he just got in. They're about 10 meters off the ground, which is a great height.
Okay.
So now we'll get up here and, I don't know if... I think we hunted... I think it was episode 4, like a year and a half ago. Aiden's first buck we shot out of this tower. And, I remember because it ran over there and it died. So it's kind of neat to be back here. I've hunted in here, you know, a bunch of times for missions and things since then. But normally I don't spend a lot of time on Logger's Point. Just because, you know, I really like a lot of the other maps. But this map has got some great open areas. It's got... You know, it's a great map. It's the only one with the mule deer. It's a great map to get the whitetail. We were talking about the rabbit earlier. I'll give away some rabbit info. Aiden, why don't you bust your calls out and start doing some calls for buck and the doe call, the buck call. There you go. Okay, so as far as rabbits go, you're going to want to spawn in at this lodge here. Some good rabbit areas. I'll tell you first my favorite. My favorite rabbit area is this area right here. This patch of woods is really, really good on rabbit. Another area would be all along this road. This is very good all the way down through here. Getting sloppy here with my coloring. Let's try that again. You've got this area you can walk down here. I've seen a few down here. Not that, again, a random spawn, you could get a bunch of them. But there's a lot of rabbit all along here, right in the center. So it's probably best to spawn at this. We don't want to fast travel. Spawning at this lodge and walk along that road. You'll start seeing rabbits... pretty much right about the time you cross about that line, they'll start kind of right in here, and you'll get some rabbits over here. I've gotten a few over there, and you know, pretty much this area all out here, there's rabbits all along this area. So like I said, you spawn in here and you work this area here, you should get plenty of rabbits. Where I see the rabbits stop is here and north. I have not run across rabbit too many times. I've seen a few around the Three Lakes area, but this is a bad area to try to hunt rabbit. This area, much better. And again, just going to draw a line. I think down south of here, I've not run into any rabbits. I don't hunt this area a lot, but I can tell you, for coyote, there's nowhere in the Hunter I think better for coyote. This is full of coyote. If you end up getting a license or a membership. And hogs are the same way. Hogs are going to be kind of throughout here. So that's just something to keep in mind. But if you were to come in to the Hunter and say, I want a cottontail rabbit right here, is a good place. Now, since we do have another free critter, let's look around and make sure we don't have any deer. I don't see anything. The other free is the European rabbit that they just put in the game about a week or two, a couple weeks ago. That's going to be found on Veldebois. There is a lodge right at the end of this road. I believe it's right there. There's a lodge here, and there's a lodge, you know, down here. Where you're going to want to spawn is at this lodge here. And I've heard rumor that along here is good on rabbit. I haven't gone over there to check too much. I have seen them around this area here. But probably the best places we've found is to spawn in here and cover this area here, because it's close to the lodge. Just walk up here and you'll start seeing a lot of the rabbits. But I think in general, they're all along here and up here. And of course, they may be all along in here too, but we've just had the best luck spawning here. And again, these just came out, so I haven't had but a couple of hunts on them. And each time I go out to hunt them, I've been spawning here and heading right over to this, you know, direction, and having pretty good luck. Those are a little bit easier to hunt because you can locate the tracks, locate the rabbit, and hunt them right out of their burrow. So, all right, well, Aiden and I did not have any luck sitting in the tower. We spent just a few minutes there. We could have definitely hung out longer, and, you know, it's hard to say what would have happened. But I wanted to go to one of our other favorite spots, and I wanted to show you also when you're out here running around, you're going to come across a lot of these, we call them orbs, it's areas that there's tracks or some kind of animal sign. It's very important to click on all of them. This case, it's a hog. That's probably the one that's up in front of us. And that'll help you, again, get leveled up. If you do shoot a mule deer, something that you could try also is before you go and you tag it, you could mark the spot of your location on the map. And that's done simply by just pressing your mouse, or you could use your binoculars to point it out. But look, you know, put the locator on your spot, and you can actually trail the animal's sign backwards. You can follow, and you can level up the tracking. You know, whether that be the actual tracks, you may see areas where the animal bedded down. You'll know if you found like fecal matter but left behind. So it's another way to help level up and make tracking a lot easier on the mule deer or whatever animal you're trying to hunt, which will definitely help you out later on if you wound an animal, trying to track it. All those things really will start to help out and make the game a little bit easier for you as you progress along. I want to try not to spook this hog, because this is a very good area. It's right there in front of us. A lot of times they travel in a large herd as well. This is a very good area to hunt. I want to keep from spooking that animal, because if it runs, it'll potentially cause everything else to run too. But we're heading up to the area that we've dubbed Evil's Rock. Again, Live Evil, our main moderator in our Twitch live streams. If you've been to our Twitch live streams, you know who he is. Good friend of mine and hunting companion. He's accompanied us on a few hunts, hasn't he, Aiden?
Yep.
So we're thinking about just getting ourselves up here, and we're going to use his spot because this is an excellent area to get a nice, almost like a tree stand view without having to buy a tree stand. And you can go prone. That's another thing why he likes it so much. When you're in those tower stands, you can crouch and go prone only looking out the back door. But to take the shots out the other walls, you're forced to stand. And standing, when you're standing, we'll focus on a point here. We'll use this rock, and I am not going to touch the mouse. And you can see how much shaking is going on. Now, if we do the same thing when we're crouched, you'll get a lot less, hold on, I gotta try that again. Focus on the rock, and I'm not touching the mouse now. A lot less movement. Again, I haven't leveled this 243 up because I own all the other guns, and so mine is fairly a new rifle as well, so it's a lot less movement, and if we go prone, you'll see the amount of movement is very little. And again, I'm not touching the mouse. The longer you stay in the aiming position, the more, you know, moving around you get. But if I was to want to shoot something far away, I would want to try to be prone and then press and hold your, I think it's your left shift. I may have changed my keys around. For me, it's left shift. And that'll cause you to hold your breath. Again, I've changed my keys around years ago, so I'm not sure by default. But, you know, there's a hold your breath button. Just look in your controls. And when you go to place your shot, hold your breath and you'll hold still. If you're crouched or prone, you should have a nice steady shot. You can get out a nice long range. So we wanted to try something else. It was raining. It rained the whole way over here.
Yeah, you can also do something else. You can find a stand, and then you can go prone. And then I saw a ton of animals. Got back up, saw an animal, shot it. It was just a...
Aiden's first video that he was ever in was episode 1 that we did in August of 2013, and he was 3.5 years old, and he had a noob account. I had bought him a few pieces of gear, but I think he might have been using the 243 during that time, and he, in that video, he killed a couple animals, so that's a 3.5 year old child that was killing animals in here and playing the game the right way. And that's what makes me laugh when there's these adults and young adults raging on Steam about not being able to kill anything. And well, honestly, I don't understand it. And clearly they're not playing the game the way that it was meant to be played. But it's not a hard game, is it, Aiden?
Nope. Not a hard game.
Not a hard game at all. You can come in here and you can harvest lots of animals, and you can even learn a thing or two about real life hunting. Granted, it is a game, but one thing it does teach you is patience. I've noticed this in my real life hunting, that I am more patient. We've got a deer really close, and we're in a bad spot. Let's walk over here. And we're in a bad spot because we're awfully close to her. All we can do is let's try to ignore that. That's something we could easily get that animal, but I want to get up to this rock because I'm kind of hoping for a buck. Getting a buck right now would be nice.
Guys, whoever has woods behind you, it's always important if you have an animal behind you, it's always important to hide so that your animal doesn't.
One of the best things you can do when you're out hunting is to, especially on maps that have a lot of rocks, which most of them do, rocks, and granted this is a huge rock, but I'm talking about a rock that maybe like the one right in front of us. Those are nice places to go prone on so that you can get off the ground, get away from the foliage, the little bushes and shrubbery, and you can get a nice, you know, steady shot without anything obstructing your view. That's a whitetail roaming over there. I think the other one, I didn't even pay attention, was a mule deer. Oops, I don't have my binoculars.
Oh, I have them. I can check.
Oops. See a deer right here, and that is, I think that's our mule deer, yeah.
Not find it.
So right there's another animal that we could kill.
That's just a nice animal.
Well, unfortunately, we're getting a lot of does here so far, but you're just as likely to come in here and get a bunch of bucks. I've spawned in, and some hunts, it's like A little bit like real life. Some days are really good, some days are not good at all.
Yep. This box is all big.
Do you have any idea where that deer went?
You want kind of where that area is.
I just want to be careful that we don't spook.
Yeah. No.
So this is that rock, ballin' on a budget, we like to call it.
Okay.
In our community, we call it the Evil's Rock. But this is a nice place because, again, you can go prone and you can look over this nice valley that's very abundant with mule deer. Again, you won't find many rabbit over here. I guess it's possible. I think I've seen one over here, but it's just not... It's not common to see coyote over here yet. One hunt not long ago I was over here, and that's all I was seeing was coyote. So you'll see a lot of hogs, and again, mule deer and whitetail. Whitetail you'll need to get a license or a membership for. And once in a while, I did this back five and a half years ago. They were running free weekends on the whitetails back then, and I would come in here and take advantage of those and really clean up on whitetail. So they do have weekends that everybody can hunt for free certain animals. I know that they've done pretty much every animal at one point or another. So you want to pay attention to that too, because that's a great way, if you really are, you know, balling on a budget, to come in and try to, you know, get a few more animals under your belt. And you could also complete more missions and earn more GMs during those free weekends that will allow you to get more ammo if you really, really, really wanted to play and didn't want to pay even a dollar for the game.
Okay.
What is that? Was that a mule deer? Yeah, it's a mule deer female. I might just have you take this one. Why don't you use your buck call?
Buck call?
Yeah, use your grunt. And I'm not expecting for us to get hordes of animals. I mean, it can easily be done over time, but when you're using guns, you're going to scare away. And there's going to be about roughly a 20 to 30 minute period that you won't see another animal. It'll take about that long for them to come back. Now, I've seen some come back within minutes, like 5 minutes, but generally... you're looking at about 20 to 30 minutes, you should expect. 15 at least. If you use a nice quiet weapon like a bow, which you'll have to use real money to get, to buy the EMs, you're looking at only about a 5 to 8 minute, maybe 5 to 10 minute time before the animals come back after you've shot. And again, that's usually only if you shoot an animal and you don't drop it in its tracks and it runs, it'll spook the other animals, but they'll come back very quickly. If you shoot, like if I were to have a bow and I shot that doe that was just down there and dropped her in her tracks, I likely would not scare the doe that was right over there, and definitely not the hog that's right over there. And so it really is kind of funny, you know, and that might be slightly unrealistic, but that's, again, a mechanic built into the game to keep it more fun. If you shoot an animal with a quiet weapon, drop it in its tracks, you won't usually spook a lot of the animals around. Sometimes you will, but it'll allow you to get right back to killing the next thing fairly quickly. So Aiden, get your 243, and there is a perfect shot for Aiden to get... put it right in the kill zone, buddy. Right in the kill zone. What? Oh, not now, it's moving.
Oh, I could.
Get ready to put it when it stops. Never try to shoot an animal that's moving. She's stuck on the rock.
That's bad. I turn around.
Get her to stop moving and... if we give her a call, she's trying to climb that rock. She's calling back. Why don't you hold your breath and get a nice shot in that kill zone. There you go. Nope, now she's moving up We've got another one behind us, so hold on, bud. We might end up having these spooked because I'm not wearing, you know, decent camo. But we're trying to be patient. Yeah, take the shot when you're ready, but hold your breath. Make sure you're holding your breath and you're nice and still. Go ahead.
Right now.
Go ahead. Yep. There you go.
What? Brighter?
Did you get a good shot on her?
Yep. She didn't actually die. Can't die, but...
A lot of noise it makes. We had another animal walking up behind, but I think it was another doe. And if you do wound an animal like he just did, it's important to give the animal some time to expire. But I'm going to walk up here and see... Uh-oh, we got body blood. Dark blood is... Oh, it's intestine. Oh, so yeah. The bad news is the animal's going to go for about 100, 150 meters. The good news is that is a for sure shot. And if we're lucky, he got the stomach or liver, which will also read as intestinal on your hunter mate. But I'm thinking... Because I know... I didn't see his shot, but he's usually pretty good. My guess is he probably got the stomach and liver, which means that they'll go, they'll only go maybe 50 to 100 meters, but you gotta give him time to lay down and die, or else you'll just chase him around the map for a long time. So, Aiden and I are just gonna head back up on the rock, and we will go track that animal in a few minutes. We'll give it about 5 to 10 minutes to do its thing, and maybe we'll get lucky and have something else come over here. All right, Aiden and I have another mule deer that has walked right up to us here. Aiden, go ahead and go prone. There you go. She's right over here, so I'm going to definitely go prone as well. See if I can get at that lung heart with my 243. Just a nice shot right there.
Oh, yeah.
Taking care of business. Very capable 243. You gotta be a little bit more careful on your shots. Only because it's not as powerful as some of the other weapons. Especially at distance. But it definitely will get the job done. And there's another one. Granted, we've been running into a bunch of does in here. But if we would have passed on these does... Who knows? You know, we could have had a bunch of bucks come in. We still may happen across some more bucks. We're probably going to fast travel to the other lodge and focus for a few minutes on a couple of those rabbit. So we're going to just go ahead and move out. And Aiden just took my doe in there for me.
Sorry.
And he was going to show it, but we'll look at it on his screen. And we're going to head over to find his. All right, so the first spot that we've got right here, we've already clicked on that one. We know it says it's intestinal blood. Again, when you go and look for your animals, it's very important, again, not to run and preferably not walk. And if you do walk, make sure that after about 25 to 50 meters, you go to a crouch walk, because otherwise you could be chasing the animal and not even know it. But we've given this animal roughly about, it's been about 10 minutes since he shot it. It only took 5 minutes to get that other mule deer in, so we could sit there all day and eventually we'd clean out the does and we'd probably have a bunch of bucks come in. Evil's killed some real monster muleys from that rock, so it's just hit or miss on, just like real life, you know, in the different hunts. You never know what you're going to get. You could come in and clean up on does. You come in and you could be a total buck hunt. I was hoping for a buck hunt today, but either way, it doesn't matter because we are we're harvesting some animals and we're leveling up our guys here. If we were newbie players, we'd be leveling up our tracking. And that's how you get better, isn't it, Aiden?
Yep.
We're just going to keep following. Once in a while when you're a new player, you got to look outside those lines, because sometimes, most of the time the animal will be within those lines, but especially when you're level 1 tracking, and I have no idea what I am on the mule deer, just probably a 4 or 5 or something like that. I don't hunt the mule deer a lot, but sometimes you'll have to look outside. Now, this is a new animal here. It wasn't a solid orb. And it says that there's a new trail found. And so I'm not gonna click on that because I wanna keep the current trail going. I just have a feeling that it says it cut to the right, but I'm kind of wondering if it didn't go more up this way. There's some orbs for another animal there. They're only a half full. See that full one in front of us? Now, I've chosen blue for my color. By default, I think it's red. I used red for several years, but I did find that blue works better on most maps. Now, Val de Bois is the one that it doesn't work as well because there's a lot of blue flowers, but here is our mule deer fleeing. That was a full. Here's a half, a couple of halves in front of us. That's probably, there was some hogs over here. But we'll keep heading in this direction. Hoping it was a stomach or liver, and she'll be down not too far over here. Got some more blood, that's good. When you get really leveled up, then you'll end up seeing like the percent of health left, so you'll kind of know about how much farther until the animal, you should find the animal. Or you'll know that the animal's not that injured and, you know, it's going to need probably another shot to bring it down. I haven't leveled up any of my animals that much in the tracking. Part of the problem is, too, is a lot of times I really try to drop my animals in their tracks, so I don't have as much tracking to do. But I guess if you're not as good with your shots, you'll be a heck of a tracker, or you'll need to become one. Are you getting all the tracking too, bud?
Not really.
Try to click on as many as you can. He likes to just follow. Oh, what do we got here? I'm gonna gamble and I'm gonna... Okay, that was a whitetail. Now that we've switched animals, which I kind of did because I felt that this deer was going to be up here, and look at what we got over here. If you... Now that we've clicked on the wrong trail, you can always go back to the last little X on your screen and re-click back on the right animal's trail and continue. Or you can gamble and walk forward, and let's just pretend in this case that this deer went over here. And this actually is from that animal. You can continue forward and it'll tell you that you've rediscovered a previous trail, and you say yes, and now I'm back on the trail of the deer. And then look, it says to go out that way, but look what we got over here. She probably was milling around when she was about to die. She was kind of going in some small circles, and that's why it has going this way, going that way. Now that one said go this way, so we'll go ahead and click on this one, and we'll see where Aiden actually hit it. Oh, he did get it back in the intestine, so he got kind of a far back shot, but it's okay. Intestinal will be a dead animal. It just so you'll have to trail it a little bit farther. If you get it in the stomach or the liver, it'll say again intestine, but it'll drop a little bit closer. Of course, lung and heart is going down. Lung a lot of times go down if it's a double lung. If it's only one lung, they'll go just a short distance with the bright pink blood and then they'll go down. So we'll go ahead and we'll get us a thumbnail. Alright, well, we've gone ahead and gotten our little thumbnail, our trophy shot. We've got another animal coming really close because I can hear it walking right up to us. We're going to move very slowly. I think it might be that whitetail, but if it's another muley, we'll go ahead and take her too. Or him. Him would be nice.
Or even a buck.
It's very, very important to crouch walk. As I can't stress it enough, if you're dressed in the newbie outfit, you really should not ever even plan to walk. That's how you can regain back your sound, sight, and your scent disadvantage, is just by crouch walking. Yes, it takes longer to get around, but if you want to have a successful hunt, you gotta do it. Well, nothing on top of this hill that I can see. It'd be handy to have the binoculars right now, but again, you always have the ability to use your scope, which this scope is fairly zoomed out, so it's not too bad, but you could do a little scan of the area. Just like real life, though, the best thing you can do is stop moving sometimes and just look in a specific spot for any kind of movement. Same rule applies when you're out hunting, and like I said, in real life, because sometimes when you're the one moving, you won't see other things moving, or definitely not other things standing still. And so just stand as still as you can, have a little look. We don't see anything. We're going to pop into the map, and we're going to see how our luck holds out with the rabbit. We'll just start walking up to the next place. There he is. Now you can fast travel every 30 minutes. So you've got... Now we'd have to wait 30 minutes before we could fast travel. And again, if you fast travel to tent or a campsite, you need to have camping supplies. There's the clay pigeon over there. And we have the rifle range where you can test out shooting at different targets. Very handy. So we're just going to continue out and head up to those areas that I've talked about for rabbit. These areas are also very good for mule deer, especially bucks. I get a lot of bucks over in this area, so I'm going to cross my fingers and hope that we come across something interesting on our walk. Well, here Aiden and I are. We're out in the little woods here, my favorite rabbit location for cottontail, probably in all of the reserve. So there's some good spots in Settlers that you can find these rabbit. I suppose I could probably point those out real quickly. There is a lodge right over in, I believe, at the end of this road. I gotta turn my drawing back on. Right here. And this pond is a great place to find rabbit. Now, a few of the guys I hunt with, they really like this area best for cottontail. And it is good. But this woods has been probably my favorite place for the cottontail to come and look for them. Whenever I have a cottontail mission or there's a contest with cottontail, I always come over here. So on the way out here, we came across a couple hogs and we came across several more mule deer doe. But I kind of decided to pass up on them. I didn't see them, but they were very close. We were getting audio calls from them. I just decided to pass on them and try to remain quiet so that we could either get some rabbit over here or kind of wait for that buck to come along. So, again, this hasn't been the most action-packed hunt, but when you're trying to focus on only two of the many critters that you have to hunt, you're going to have less kills per hunt, but I can tell you that's not always true, because I've come out here, even now as a member, and absolutely cleaned up on mule deer. And just the other day we were out hunting, and I think Evil had four or five or six mule deer bucks that had all come in nearly at the same time, and I've seen it many times myself. So if you're quick shooting, there's definitely some opportunities. So we've got our first bunny. I love this little clearing. I think that's a bunny out there. I'm going to have to get my... Yeah, right there's one. This little log clearing. We'll check the map again. You can see right where we are. It's right on the back side of this woods. It's very easy to find. Right off the road. There's always rabbit out here. The pellet rifle is an excellent choice because it's quiet, as well as the crossbow and the other bows to take on these rabbit. But those you have to pay EMs, payroll money for, so obviously we're not using them today. But I've sat out here on the edge of this little clearing and just killed plenty of rabbits without barely having to move. I'm going to spook it if I get too much closer. fact, I think I just did. Let it run around.
I know rabbits are hard to kill.
Yeah. I definitely spooked it. I was trying to get in a little bit closer, but we're not using any camo or anything. I definitely could have taken it at the range that I was. A lot of times these rabbits will, the cottontail, just like in real life, they will lay low, and sometimes you'll nearly step on them before they take off. They're always going to look for some kind of vegetation or something. I think there's another one over here. Well, it's probably that stick I was looking at. This is where a pair of binoculars for only 40 EMs come in handy. I'm not sure if you can use GMs to buy them. I like to use the rangefinders, which are about 700 EM, or roughly $6 or $7 US. Make sure you're using birdshot, not buckshot or slugs on these rabbits, or they'll be disqualified. You technically can kill the rabbits with the 243. They're not going to show up in your inventory, but if you're really out here your trophy case rather, if you're really out here for the sake of entertainment, you're going to get what's called a letter from Doc is the game warden in the Hunter, and he'll tell you that you're disqualified, you're using the wrong caliber weapon. Oh, here we go. That one ran right over to us. And so now we got ourselves a little rabbit there. Makes a big blood spot.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's kind of a mess.
Yeah. I feel like jumping right in it.
I know.
For a bath.
Oh, that'd be an icky bloodbath.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see what we got on our rabbit here. Pretty much hit it all over the place. Why don't you come on, let's grab a quick pick. Okay. Well, there's one rabbit. And so you could sit out here for an hour or many hours and really just clean up on these rabbits. Now, the European hare, which is on Vel de Bois, those would be even better if you were looking for something free to shoot at, because they run in their burrows, and like clockwork, no matter if you're using a loud gun or not, within 5 minutes or so, they'll come out of the burrow, and you'll be able to shoot them, and once you shoot them, they all run back in the burrow, so you pretty much know where they're going to pop out. Now, the burrows will have, like, 4, 5, 6, I've seen as much as 7 openings, but they always go in and come out of that same spot, and as far as using a loud shotgun, they are so much fun. It's like playing whack-a-mole. And that's a new critter they just added in a few weeks ago. So definitely, if you've been away from the game, go and check that out, because they are a lot of fun. And especially if you're only using loud, you know, shotguns, rifles, things like that, it's perfect for doing that, for hunting does. Now, the cottontail, they're kind of like every other animal. When you shoot a loud gun, they scatter, and then you've got to kind of locate them. But at the end of the day, I've used shotguns for the missions on the rabbit many a times. In a short amount of time, clean up a handful of rabbit. You know, they'll run a short distance, you'll shoot another one, and it just keep moving around. But stop to make sure that you listen, because that's important with these rabbits. Sometimes I'll even alt-tab out of the game and be checking out stuff on the web. And you'll all of a sudden hear the sound, the chick-chick-chick-chick, and there's another rabbit. Yeah, we got a pheasant over there. That'd be another animal that we could kill with our shotgun. With the bird shot.
Yeah, but they're always good.
Yeah, you'll need a membership or a license to do so, and granted, they do run some free weekends, so that's something else you could use your shotgun on if you went the shotgun route. This is, I think, the only weapon currently that you can unlock with GM. All the other weapons would need to be purchased with EMs, which, again, is done with real money. Well, Aiden and I have walked all the way over to this area that I had talked about earlier for being really good on, looks like Aiden was drawing on the map, as far as being a good area for bucks, and we just got a call from a buck that's right over off to our left. We've already called it. I'm gonna give a doe bleat. Really, as far as from what I know, I don't ever use a doe bleat. We are, because that's what you get for free. I always use the buck call. I don't think there's really a difference, though. Both work on the whitetail and the mule and the blacktail. Eden's prone right now, and I probably should be too, but I'm having a feeling that those trees are going to get in the way. Why don't you get up, crouch walk, and follow me? I got to worry less about him and more about me. This rock right here would be an excellent choice. That's why I said always look around for a rock that you can get up onto. Now I can go prone. We've got good visibility. This buck is very close. He's over here. Okay. I haven't spotted him yet. Aiden, get up here and get comfortable.
Get comfortable. Mm-hmm. My sleep bed.
Yeah, in your little sleepy bed on a rock.
Yeah.
Why don't you give out another buck call? I think he's right there. Well, maybe not. But yeah, it's just very important. Just take your time.
I'm gonna have a little.
Yep. There's no telling what this buck is. Eden's looking through the binoculars. Oh, you see him. There he is.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Neither one of us are wearing scent spray. He's a small mule, but...
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Get your gun, because...
What kind of gun?
Well, your rifle.
I got it.
Go ahead and,
give it a shot?
Yeah, go ahead and make sure you're holding your breath, though. Make sure you get in on that kill zone.
Okay.
Hold your breath and give it a shot.
What's fire? That's what I said.
Oh, I did not want him to get away.
Nope.
I think I ended up hitting him on the second. I normally would not ever do that. But Aiden and I don't normally hunt with these 243, and I didn't want to continue out the video. But he doesn't know how to follow up his shots very good with the reloading and then like getting back on target. Yeah, just being barely 5 years old, it's a little difficult for him. But if you get the animal close enough, you can very easily get a second shot when it's running away, especially when you're in the open like that. Any normal player, any adult player, young adult would be able to, to easily have those skills to have a follow-up shot. So I didn't have a chance to look at Aiden's monitor to see where he was aiming when he hit it, but I did not want it to get away. That'll be our buck that we came out here. We passed on another doe on the way from the rabbit area. I'll show our location. We basically just, like I said, walked from up here where we were talking with you last. We were right in here. We kind of continued out here and came down to that buck area that I talked about. It's always a good idea to mark on the map with your binoculars or anything to mark approximately where your animal is down. If you're using the, I think the regular binoculars do it. I'm not positive. I haven't used them in several years, but I know the rangefinder and the rangefinding binoculars, you can mark a spot with that. And I usually will mark the spot where my animal's down, because you'd be surprised when you get close. Sometimes they'll hide in the foliage, and it just helps you locate that animal a little bit easier when you see it drop like we did. I think ours is right up here. Oh, right here, yep. As you've seen in the live streams, if you've watched him in other videos, he's really good at getting those lung and heart. But this is our little buck. It's a very small mule deer, but we could have come out here in this small hunt and killed a pile of critters, especially if we had... theoretically, if we had our memberships and stuff, we would have been able to clean up a lot more. But Aiden and I are trying to only kill the free animals, so we've passed on all those, even though we are both members and we plan on being for many more years to come. But Aiden got a shoulder blade, and he got a left lung, so that would have been a dead animal, and I'm the one that shot it in the right hind leg. So Aiden had the good shot. Good job. Sorry I took your massive animal.
Oh, that's okay. Sorry.
I wanted to make sure he didn't get away, and I knew it was a very small mule deer, so we'll go ahead and get us a little picture with this. All right, well, that will be the conclusion to our beginner's guide video. Aiden, did you have fun on this one?
Sure did.
That's good. I know it was a lot different than what we normally do. For those of you that have been fans of our channel, you know, and you're looking for some action-packed, I highly encourage you to check out our other videos. This is not normally something we do, but I've wanted to make a beginner's guide for a long time, and when this game hit Steam back in August, it really further motivated me after some of the reviews that I was reading, the very unfair reviews, to make a beginner's guide so that at least these people don't have as many excuses to be ragging on a game that they are totally off on those reviews. Most 99% of the reviews are completely dead wrong. So if you're looking for arcade fun, you know, which I am not a fan of, then you might want to go look at Cabela's or something like that. This is a hunting simulator. This is about hunting. This is trying to make it as realistic as possible while still being fun. This is a hunting game. That's why they've given it the appropriate title, The Hunter. So if you're looking for hunting, I don't believe you will find anything better. I know you won't. There's nothing out there at the caliber of this game. These folks have been around for 6 years now with this title. I see it not even halfway in its development. I mean, it's really phenomenal. Don't mistake it either for early access or something like that. It's not. It's a fully finished game. It's just one that is evolving, and they're always adding and changing, and that's what we love so much about it. So if you are a new player, I highly encourage you to come over to our Steam community. I will put the link in the description below. Jump on over there, and you can get linked up with some veteran hunters, people that will help you and show you how to play. But if you come into our Twitch channel, you will also find more hunters in there, people to link up, play multiplayer with. You can use our TeamSpeak, and you never know which one of your favorite YouTubers you might run into over at the GunninGamerz TeamSpeak community. So I highly encourage you to click on those links below and get yourself set up. Come into our community. We'd love to help you out. If you're a new player, let somebody know, and we'll try to do our part to help you out and maybe give you a few pointers. And of course, if you've watched Aiden and I's videos, and if you're watching us 3 days a week on Twitch, our live streams, we live stream the game quite a bit, don't we? Usually about one day at least a week, sometimes all three. That's Wednesday, Saturday, and Sunday evenings. We live stream, we'll show the hunter, and you can pick up a lot of tips and even meet new players and other veteran hunters there. So I highly recommend it. It's one of our staple games here. We love it dearly. We can't wait to see what the future holds, like the Australian map that's coming, the Australian reserve that they've recently announced. So it's like I said, folks, there's so much to do and see. If you decide to get into it, my recommendation is go and purchase the Trail Runner, I believe it's called, membership, which is $50. That's the price of a normal game. That'll give you a one-year membership. It gives you a pile of a bow, a shotgun, rifle, some handgun, at least one, and a couple other rifles. It'll give you unlimited ammo, a bunch of calls. It'll give you the whole Boone and Crockett outfit for free. Check it out on their website. It is a phenomenal value, and that gear you get to keep forever. Now, when your membership runs out after a year, it literally will only cost you a couple dollars a month to get another year's membership. So check it out. I encourage you to. We love it. Aiden, do you have any last thoughts?
Well, this game, I mean, you could kill about like 100 million deer every single day. It's a perfect game for you to buy, And maybe you could get all your games, many games as like I have Gold Sim, Farming, I will call it Minecraft.
I think we want to probably focus on the Hunter here. We want them to buy the Hunter. Don't buy Goat Simulator. You can't hunt goats in there. But maybe no. In the future you can in the Hunter. Maybe. We kind of have where you can go hunt the Ibex. So it's kind of like goat. So, folks, definitely don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And until next time,
Here.
We'll see you then.